It's a European country, as you all know by now. So, Austria, officially the Republic of Austria, is a landlocked East Alpine country in the southern part of Central Europe. The country covers an area of 983,871 kilometers square. The country is mostly dominated in the west and south by mountains, the Alps. And you know, the highest point, the highest mountain in Austria is Grossglockner Mountain, and with a height of 3,798 meters. That's quite huge, right? So here you can see the red highlighted region. This is Austria. These are the states of Austria, and you can see that it's surrounded by Germany, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Italy, Switzerland, Croatia, and Hungary. Let's talk about the national flag of Austria. So the Austrian flag is a rectangular tri-band flag with colors red and white. The three equal horizontal bands are arranged with a red at the top and bottom with a white band in the middle. Let's note that what do they represent? The red color of the flag is associated with love, open-mindedness, war, and supremacy, hence signifying the strength and bravery. Every country holds a history, as you all know, and Austria is no different. The history of Austria covers the history of Austria and its predecessor states from the early Stone Age to the present state. The name Austrarchy, which was the former name of Austria, has been in use since 996 AD when it was Margraviate of the Duchy of Bavaria, and from 1156 an independent duchy, later it was known as Archduchy of the Holy Roman Empire of the German nation. Austria was dominated by the House of Habsburg and House of Habsburg-Lorraine from 1273 to 1918. In 1806, when Emperor Francis II of Austria dissolved the Holy Roman Empire, Austria became the Austrian Empire and was also part of the German Confederation until the Austro-Prussian War of 1866. In 1867, Austria formed a dual monarchy with Hungary, the Austro-Hungarian Empire. When this empire collapsed after the end of World War I in 1918, Austria was reduced to the main, mostly German-speaking area of the empire and adopted the name of the Republic of German Austria. However, union with Germany and the chosen country name were forbidden by the Allies at the Treaty of Versailles. This led to the creation of the First Austrian Republic. Following the First Republic, Austrofascism tried to keep Austria independent from German Reich. Engelbert Dollfuss accepted the most Austrians were German and Austrian, but wanted Austria to remain independent from Germany. In 1938, Austrian-born Adolf Hitler annexed Austria to the German Reich with the Anschluss, which was supported by a large majority of the Austrian people. 10 years after the Second World War, Austria again became an independent republic as the Second Austrian Republic in 1955. So you must be knowing about Adolf Hitler. Is there anyone?
No.
So he was the dictator. He is known for his dictatorship. He hated Jews. He killed them. and you will like study about him when you will grow up. And he also had his own army, and his army was known as Nazi army. Let's know about the capital of Austria. It's Vienna.
I
Know about what, Aran?
its capital, Vienna.
Okay. And do you know that this is the largest city of Austria?
I didn't know that.
It is the capital and the largest city of Austria.
Oh.
And it covers an area of 414.6 kilometers square. So, as it is a European country, so the official language of this country is German.
It uses euro.
Come again? What were you saying?
It uses euro.
Yeah, we'll talk about it. We'll talk about the
The
country.
currency.
So the population is 8.86 million here. Let's talk about the government. So the government of Austria is the executive cabinet of the Republic of Austria. It is composed of the chancellor, who is the head of the government, the vice chancellor, and the ministers. So they have chancellor and vice chancellor. Chancellor is Sebastian Kurz. The currency, as you told Arhan, it's euro. And do you know what value do it hold in Indian rupee? It's approximately 90 rupees. 1 euro.
90 rupees, ma'am. Ma'am,
Yes, 90 rupees.
I have 20 euro. Can you see, ma'am?
Yes, that's good.
Actually, Austria's currency is Australian shilling.
Come again?
Australian's currency is shilling. Australian shilling.
I'm sorry, Sudarshan, but today we are discussing about Austria. Let's talk about the sports. So they play association football and alpine skiing or downhill skiing and ice hockey. The climate of Austria now. The climate of Austria can be classified as CFB climate, a warm, temperate, humid climate with the warmest month lower than 72 degrees Fahrenheit, which is around about 22 degrees Celsius, and over average, and four or more months above 50 Fahrenheit, which is around 10 degrees Celsius over average. The climate of the mountainous regions of Austria can be classified as GFB climate, a humid snow climate with the warmest month between 50 and 72 degrees Fahrenheit, which is round about 12 to 22 degrees Celsius. The coldest month below 26 degrees Fahrenheit, which is around minus 3 degrees Celsius. That's quite shivering, right? And at last, 4 or more months above 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 10 degrees Celsius. Let's talk about the wildlife. You can see many animals, right? So, there is predominantly Central European fauna in Austria with species that include deer, stag, rabbit, pheasant, fox, badger, marten, and partridge. You can see there. If we are talking about a country, then how can we miss about their cuisine, right? So, the first one comes Tefal Spitz, which is possibly one of the most popular dishes that can be found in Austria. And the name refers to the cut of meat, which is known as the tri-tip. Tefal Spitz is generally considered to be the national dish of Austria. And it is boiled beef broth, which is then served with horseradish, root vegetables, spices, and minced apples. Then Wiener Schnitzel. This dish is a thin breaded and deep fried meat dish usually made from veal. The veal is butterfilled and whipped together with eggs and breadcrumbs in order to make it light. Then it is fried to a crispy texture. The next one on the list is Wiener Würstchen. It is readily available everywhere. The sausage was originally invented by a butcher in Vienna and are similar to the hot dogs that can be found that in America. These long, thin and tasty snacks truly are delicious. The next one is Apfelstrudel. It is a popular pastry dish often associated with Vienna in particular. It is a traditional apple strudel and is a thin apple filled pastry which includes cinnamon sugar and raisins. This is the perfect breakfast or dessert dish and is often accompanied with a cup of coffee. The next one is Kaiserschmarrn. If you are looking for a dessert in Austria, then it is a fit for an emperor. Then make sure to turn to this dish. This dish consists of fluffy caramelized pancake that is torn up and sprinkled with sugar and some form of hot fruit compote. So this seems delicious, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's discuss about the airline industry of Austria. The Austrian Air is the national airline of this country. Austrian Airlines, sometimes shortened to Austrian, is the flag carrier of Austria and a subsidiary of the Lufthansa Group. Airline is headquartered on the grounds of Vienna International at Schwechat, where it is also maintains its hub. As of July 2016, the airline flew to 6 domestic and more than 120 international year-round of seasonal destinations in 5 countries and is a member of the Star Alliance. The Austrian Airlines fleet currently consists of 83 aircraft, which are divided into the long haul fleet and the short and medium haul fleet. World Airlines Awards in 2019. So Austrian Airlines was once again given a top ranking in the renowned Skytrax World Airline Awards in 2019. Austria's national carrier won the world title in the category of Best Premium Economy Class Onboard Catering. Austrian Airlines improved its overall ranking and moved up one place to 15th position. You can see the picture of this aircraft. So here we come to an end. I'll request my guests if they have any facts to share. So go ahead, one by one, please.
Symbol of Austria is black eagle, called coat of arms.
Repeat.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Yes.
Ma'am, Austria is famous for its castles, palaces, and buildings.
All right, that's good to know. And what about other people, other participants?
Ma'am, Australian people are very friendly and good natured.
Ten best places to visit in Austria. Number 10. Bad Gastein.
Landlocked country. Ma'am, Austria is a landlocked country and it has a very a variety of different landscapes.
Okay.
It has the largest European lake.
Okay. Thank you for sharing. So do you know which country we are going to visit tomorrow?
Canada.
Yes.
Canada?
Yes.
Canada we are going to visit.
UK?
Yes. No, it's Canada. So who all are here who loves to painting, who loves to draw? Just raise your hand. Okay, Rohita. Ansh. Okay, Arhan, Arika, and? So I have a task for you.
What?
That you have to draw a flag of Canada. All right? Great, Arika.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Tomorrow in the class, I'll show you tomorrow.
Ma'am, we must draw flag of Canada.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
So and see you tomorrow.
And ma'am, it has a maple leaf inside it.
Yes. That you have to explain, Arhan.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Bye, ma'am.
See you, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.